So in this video, we're talking about a GPU. What is it? And how does it relate to graphic designers, video editors, or just creative professionals as a whole? Well, you're gonna learn that all in this video coming at you right now. I'm Benji Kaiser, and you're watching Don't Tech With Me, the place for creative professionals to learn about tech, as well as the best laptops and new releases coming your way. So if that sounds like your kind of place, consider subscribing and ring the bell so you don't miss out on any of the future videos. Right now, we're talking specifically about GPUs. We're gonna head on over to the slides here and talk through what is a GPU? Well, it is a graphics processing unit or video card. And really, when you think about a GPU, you usually think about the big, bulky unit that you see most often in desktops. But this is not what the GPU actually is completely made up of. This is the entire package. The actual graphics card is something like this. Now, this is a dedicated graphics card that would be inside of a laptop. This is the MX350. But this entire unit is what makes up the graphics processing unit. But the graphics card is this. So right off the bat, that's a distinguisher we want to make. Okay, now there's two types of GPUs. An integrated GPU, that's a graphics processing unit that is built into a computer, a central processing unit, a CPU, of a laptop or desktop computer. It shares the RAM with the CPU, so it has to share the computer's RAM along with the CPU to pull its power. Whereas you have a discrete GPU, and I kind of find that word amusing because there's nothing really discrete about that, but a discrete GPU or a dedicated GPU, and this is a separate dedicated component within the computer. It has its own RAM memory, VRAM, so it does not have to pull from the computer's bank of RAM. So RAM stands for random access memory. And if you're curious more about random access memory, we're going to link up a video in the YouTube cards above, and we'll have a full playlist explaining RAM on the channel. So VRAM is a graphics processing unit's dedicated RAM. So what this does is it allows the computer to save its RAM for other tasks and dedicate the VRAM to graphics processing tasks. Okay, so what is in a dedicated GPU? Well, inside a dedicated GPU is its own CPU, its own RAM, VRAM, a dedicated BIOS chip, and for AMD, something called stream processors, and for NVIDIA, something called CUDA cores. Now, you've heard of cores within a CPU, you know, one core, two core, now we're up to six core, eight core, so on and so forth. But this is specifically cores inside of a GPU. And there's way, way more cores inside of a GPU than there are a CPU. And we'll talk about all this stuff more in depth in other videos. But for now, we're just getting the general build out of a GPU. So what does the GPU do? Well, it's responsible for rendering graphics. Well, what kind of graphics? So let's talk about it. As a video editor or graphic designer, or motion designer, or any other designer that you can think of, maybe an architect, what are you using your GPU for? The GPU supports the CPU by sending the GPU a message to help it render the footage of, say, a video editing project, or a 3D animation, or an architectural rendering, or animation, so on and so forth. So it can focus on other equally important but less graphical tasks. So to explain that, you have the CPU, okay? So you're working inside of a project and all of a sudden you hit the timeline. You hit play on the timeline and the timeline starts rolling to show you your footage or show you the animation. So immediately the CPU says, hey, graphical task. So it pushes information, it executes a code that sends to the GPU and says, hey, I need your help. So what happens is the GPU picks up some of that visual rendering load of the image happening in the timeline in, say, Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve or After Effects, and it starts to pull power. So that way, let's say 30% of the rendering and visuals go to the RAM, and then it pulls 15 to 20% of the way away from the CPU. And then that way, the CPU can focus on other tasks and not get pulled down, and you can have a better performing computer. Okay. So from here, it works in the playback and timeline. It works in rendering. So whenever you're in Premiere Pro and you click, you know, render, so it renders out your project or your animations, or if you're doing an entire visual animation, click render, and this is where the GPU takes over. The GPU speeds up the process of smoothing the 3D dimensional edges of your footage or animation. The GPU does not take responsibility for exporting. So I know a lot of people say, okay, does the GPU help with exporting? It does not. And the GPU is best used for creative professionals in Premiere Pro, After Effects, DaVinci Resolve, Sony, Vegas, Blender, CAD, so on and so forth. So the question then becomes, what is the GPU for graphic design? And honestly, as a whole, nothing. The GPU is not used for graphic design. I have a lot of people ask me, they come on the channel and say, hey, you know, I'm a graphic designer, I'm working with graphics, do I need a graphics processing unit? And this is where I think it should really be renamed as like visual graphics or video graphics card, which people do call a video card sometimes, but really the general term as a whole in the industry is GPU or graphics processing unit. I understand the confusion. I thought that a lot when I was first getting into the industry, figuring out what computer I needed. But as we look at the capabilities of it being more of a render-based product, more of something that deals with the timeline and what displays on your screen, so it's having to communicate all that information onto your screen and visually decode it. So the CPU is able to handle the rendering of graphics in InDesign, Illustrator, Photoshop, and Affinity. So really, your CPU is going to take a brunt of the load for graphic design, whereas the CPU might call on the GPU to help in some crazy animation you've created in Photoshop, but that is going to be a minimal situation. So let's say you create this huge project that has tons of visualization and needs a ton of help re-imposing that onto your screen. You might pull a little bit of power from the GPU, but that is a rare case. So do you need to know more about the GPU other than what we've covered today? Not necessarily. If you're a video editor or if you're a graphic designer, you have a lot of the information that you need. Now the question from here comes, which GPU is right for you? So before we continue on to this slide and talk through this, let's look at how I think it's best to really understand what GPU you should be purchasing. So the best way to do it is obviously watch one of my videos where I can talk through, you know, the best GPUs or the best laptops for video editing or graphic design. But then what you can do is you can look at the laptops I'm recommending over on my other channel, Benji Kaiser, if you check that out, and you can see, okay, Ben's recommending a laptop that has a, let's say, 1050 Ti. So we'll search that on userbenchmark.com. So a GTX 1050 Ti. Okay, well, I'm looking at a laptop that has a MX250. There we go, they have an MX250. And right away we see, okay, wow, the GTX 1050 Ti completely crushed the MX250, okay? Now, we have another laptop, right? Okay, this laptop has a 1650 Max Q. Okay, that sounds more powerful. It's only 8% more powerful. So if this laptop here is a better buy than this laptop here, well, then we should probably go with that GTX 1050 Ti. So, you know, you could see this bigger number and think, okay, 1650, that sounds like a really great GPU. It sounds like a lot more powerful. But then we come in here and compare benchmark to benchmark, and we see that, okay, it's barely faster. So this would be a better, more cost-effective solution. So that's one way you can really start to understand which GPU you should buy and the choices that you make when making a purchasing decision. Okay, so let's jump back into this slide. What is a dedicated GPU's CPU or CUDA cores, stream processors, VRAM, GPU BIOS chips? What does all this mean? I'm creating a full playlist explaining all the different GPU classifications, what the components that are inside of them. So you can head on over to the channel and check out that playlist if you want to know more about your graphics processing unit. For now, this is a basic walkthrough of GPUs. Thanks for watching Don't Tech With Me. I'll see you on the next episode.